Zilla. I haven't actually met one yet, and Charlie has been amazing. Her organisational skills is where we are today, along with Brendan, who wanted to be totally involved, and he has been. I'm supposed to say terribly nice things about Charlie. She said, please, Mommy, don't tell any of your story. I don't know what I'll do. So I'm not going to. I just like to say that Charlie was the best baby. She never gave me a day's trouble as a child. Then there was this slight little hiccup where her name became Trouble. Recently, she has travelled around the world and back again. And by that I mean she is now living in Greystones, which she loves, and Brendan with her. And when we were first living in Greystones, and she was a teenager, she used to say to me, why on earth did you ever buy a house in Greystones? It is so far out. There's no shops. There's nothing to do.
Congratulations to the bride and groom, and to those who are not able to be with us.
Bride and
groom.
To the bride and groom.
Bride and groom.
Well done, Judy. Might be about to come forward.
Sure, well done.
It's been really lovely getting to know everybody the last few days. And in case you forgot my name, I'm Katie.
These last few years, I have become very, very good friends with Charlie. In fact, she has become family to me. She's the sister I always wanted, always needed, and never had. From the moment I met Charlie, she has been this source of
of encouragement
and enthusiasm and love. She has taught me that in order to be happy, you have to add an element of a fearless adventure into every day. And that by being just that bit more brave than usual, good things will come.
Hello, guys. We made it to the church on time, and I'm referring to myself and Tommy today. Sorry, firstly, for missing the rehearsal. Things did get out of hand. It's amazing, guys. I'm so honored that Brandon has picked me to be the best man.
It's my first time, by the way, so I'm very nervous. So I got very good advice today from Dennis and Mary. It was, make this about Brandon. I have been very, very nervous. And I haven't known what to say. But when they told me that, it all made sense. Let's make it about Brandon. It's okay.
When I first met Brandon, I went, that guy is just too positive. He's going to crack, but he's not. It's him. He's genuine. It's amazing. You need more Brandons in your life. You really do. It got better when I met Charlie. We all have couple friends. We all have favorites in those couples. There's nothing worse than having a great favorite and not liking the other half of the couple. We get forced into these relationships as we get older. I don't have that problem with these guys. I actually like both of them equally. I'm delighted to have them in my life. I'm honored today. I'm so thankful, guys. Really. I don't cry at weddings. But I got a big Christian today on the beach. I love you. I love you, man. I really do. Guys, thank you very much. Let's have fun, Brian Boom.
Capacity you had. Now, I need a special thank you to my cousin Anne-Marie and Charles.
They made it all the way from New York. Yeah. Yeah. No, to all of you, you did such a wonderful job getting here in your own capacity, and we really appreciate it. After that, I hope you all enjoyed your dinner. Good, good. I owe a special thank you to Deanne for making this day as beautiful as it is. To Andre for banging out the tunes all night. Now, to be fair, I did half your job for you, Charlie and I did, by giving you all the music. No, I'm only joking. You've been rocking it out all night. And thank you so much. The best DJ on Mykonos. I owe an exceptional thanks, and Dad mentioned that he forgot it, to the Termin Fecton crew. In their hearts and their own spirits, and also to two Cork folks sitting over there. I think they gave my best man a bit of advice, but I'm not sure. Richie nailed the speech. I owe a wonderful thank you to everyone who made their speeches today. Thank you to Alan for his beautiful, kind, embracing words. To Eugenie for welcoming into our family. To my father for his short and sweet, and also throwing Richie in the deep end words. And then to Richie for saying some of the kindest words I've ever heard uttered in my own, like, towards me. And I won't get used to that. It's the first time you're ever nice to me.
Richie.
Don't worry. To Katie. For saying one of the most beautiful speeches that some Charlie and I up that I have ever heard. Yeah. I owe a very special thank you to Helen and Alan for their generous contribution. They, without them, most of what you see here wouldn't have happened. It would have been paper plates and plastic cups. So, thank you. To my parents for giving you the meal tonight. That was on them. To Mike and Annie for their wonderful contribution that will keep us all inebriated tonight. To my beautiful bride for saying yes. I put her in a terrible position on Valentine's Day in Paris at sunset on the Lovelock Bridge. So if she said no, I really did a bad job. I owe a special thank you to Nikos. Not just Nikos, but your father. Without both of you, this place wouldn't exist. We wouldn't have the wedding of our dreams. And we wouldn't look at such a beautiful place. Yeah. Our hearts and thoughts are with him.
Yeah. Thank you.
I'm sure he is as wonderful as you, and you have touched our hearts and touched our souls to the point that I thought you'd chop us up and lock us in your basement the day we meet you. I had no idea what we were walking into. But this guy was so sweet from the start. I was like, alright. Some sort of horrible shack on a hill. And we're gonna walk in, there's just gonna be meat hooks everywhere. And people just lying everywhere. I was like, well, let's try it out. This could be a good venue. No, Nikos, thank you. And not just for the venue, but for being you.
Thank you.
Special energy to our wedding that I can't sum up in words as much as I talk. You're a wonderful person. You're amazing. And I'm not finished with you. Hilda. The woman behind the man. Charlie and I hope to be good parents. And if I can be one ounce of what they are, I'm going to be an amazing father. And Charlie will be an amazing mother. They got me here. They got me here safe, unhungover. And unscathed, which Richie will tell you is a miracle. Honestly, I couldn't have asked for two better people in my life, not just parents. And I'm honored that they are sitting there next to me for the entire evening. Although I hope they outdance me tonight. I'm trying to figure out who else I have to thank. I pretty much got everybody out there. Finished. I mean, Annie, of course. You didn't escape. No. So Charlie met Anna when she first came over to Mykonos, and Anna took her in with open arms and a gigantic heart, unlike any other person who's ever graced Hotel Del Pigou. And Yanni, in his quiet but adoring way, was always there with a hug. And to make fun of you when you needed it. I love you both. I'm so honored to meet both of you. I can't wait to see you next year. And as long as I'm not refused after what happens later tonight. I hope you all have a wonderful evening. I really hope I haven't forgot anyone in particular. If I have, I'm genuinely sorry. But each and every one of you are so important to Charlie and I that it's our dream that you are all here with us. Now, lastly, you won't be cold much longer. There's tons of my booze behind the bar and Metaxa, which is a Greek brandy. Try some. Michael knows about Metaxa. Enjoy yourself, party, and believe me, you'll be sweating in about 10 minutes. If Andreas has anything to say about it, he'll be banging out those tunes so our legs fall off. Have a wonderful night. I love you all.